I took a poll on Twitter because, as you can tell, my voice is not right, and I think that I'm getting sick, but I wanted to try to do the video anyways, and although most of you were pretty supportive, I think the general consensus was that you guys wanted me to try to do the video regardless. So, the show must go on. I'm here today to talk about Cardano, which is also known as ADA or ADA, and the reason I'm talking about this coin is, well, I was bombarded by people to cover it, but also it's something that I have invested in myself, and that I think that it's a pretty cool project. So it took me a long time to do the write-up and do the research, because as most of you probably know, or have done research on your own and figured out, it's a really tech-heavy project, and it's a really dense read. So I wanted to make sure that I got everything right. Let's get into it. Cardano was named after Giuliano Cardano, and he was an Italian polymath from the 1500s. He was known as one of the most influential mathematicians of the Renaissance. ADA, or ADA, which is the coin that powers the Cardano blockchain, was named after Ada Lovelace. She was a famous English mathematician from the 1800s. She was famous for being the first to recognize the full potential of a computing machine, and she was technically the first computer programmer. The project was established by Charles Hoskinson. You've probably heard his name before, or he sounds at least relatively familiar, and that's because he was a former CEO of Ethereum and also the co-founder of Ethereum. He partnered with the Cardano Foundation around 2015. The Cardano ICO took place over four stages, and it was a little long-winded. It started in September 2015, and it ended in January 2017. They had really heavy KYC requirements, or know your customer requirements. Cardano is a third generation cryptocurrency. And what that means is that its ethos is to resolve the issues that we see with major blockchain tech now, which is scalability, sustainability, and interoperability. Cardano was made up of three different companies that have distinct roles in the project. The first is the Cardano Foundation. It is a Swiss organization that's nonprofit, and its main job is to oversee the Cardano ecosystem and most of the Cardano community. It aims to proactively work with governments and regulatory bodies, as well as oversee partnerships to further mass adoption. The second company that's part of the project is IOHK, and that stands for Input Output Hong Kong. It's an engineering company that was created by Charles Hoskinson and Jeremy Wood. Their goal is to use peer-to-peer innovations to provide financial services to 3 billion people in the world who don't have access to them. The third and final portion of the Cardano project is Emergo, and it's a venture capital company. Its role is to invest in startups and assist with ventures that are going to start building on the Cardano blockchain. On to the ICO. The ICO was marketed as an investment to retire on, and it was marketed primarily to the Japanese. In fact, 95% of the people that participated in the ICO were of Japanese descent. The ICO oversaw a sale of about 26 billion out of the 45 billion total supply of ADA available. That equates to about 63 million in US dollars. Now for some more specifics about Cardano. Cardano's goal is to create a platform for smart contracts to be utilized on, but they're also focusing on security by utilizing a layered architecture. It's similar to Ethereum that it's a platform for smart contracts, but it's also extremely different in its underlying technology. ADA runs on Ouroboros, and it's the only DPoS, or delegated proof of stake system, that has gone through a peer review process. This means they've gone through the process of getting a paper accepted at an academic conference. And according to the chief scientist at IOHK, it's also supported by formal security proof. Cardano boasts that their network offers deep functionality, which comes with speed, small fees, and efficiency. Eventually, there's going to be a treasury model too, which is similar to Dash, and so people will be able to vote on changes to the ecosystem and things that they want to improve. They also plan to be compliant with all different regulators from different jurisdictions. That's going to be a pretty serious undertaking. So what's unique about this project? Cardano was the first project to be built on peer-reviewed academic research, and it was built from scratch using the functioning programming language Haskell. IOHK hired Philip Wadler. He's a principal designer of Haskell, and he was hired to work on Cardano's project. According to Hoskinson, because Haskell is more similar to math in its approach, code can be written in a more precise manner. This results in an overall more secure and reliable protocol. It minimizes the number of errors and adds extremely strong security to the platform. Their aim is to use blockchain technology to bring in distributed institutions, such as things like insurance and banking, and they want to bring it to the whole world, especially the developing nations. Let's talk a little bit about the technology aspect of Cardano, since that's a pretty important component. Cardano is being designed in two layers. One is the ledger of account values, and the other is the reason why the account values have moved to someone else's account. This enables the smart contracts that were written on the platform to be more customizable and flexible. The first layer is the Cardano settlement layer, or the CSL. and it acts as the account ledger, but also the first layer of the platform. Created as an improvement to Bitcoin, this is where the DPoS consensus protocol, Ouroboros, is located. The second layer is the Cardano computational layer, or CCL. Say that three times fast. And this is a separate layer in which executable code will be run on. Sophisticated decentralized applications, or dApps, and smart contracts will be able to run independently on this layer. The next important feature I want to touch on is sidechains. Cardano will be using the KMZ sidechains, and this basically is just an acronym for the names of the people that designed it. It's going to allow funds to move from the CSL to the CCL or any other blockchain that uses that protocol. Charles Hoskinson has been seen on Twitter talking to Charlie Lee about possibly him donating some engineers to maybe integrate some Litecoin usage. Now the wallet. The wallet I've seen people complaining about some issues with. I myself had a little bit of a problem with it. It seemed to sync really slow, but then other people have told me that they didn't experience the same problem. So I don't know, maybe if it's the speed of my internet, maybe I had to restart my computer. I don't know. Say Dallas is a desktop wallet in which you can store your ADA tokens. Eventually, it's going to be a multi-currency wallet in which you can freely exchange the supported currencies using atomic swaps. The cool part about the wallet is that it's built on a web-based platform, and this means that people will be able to design applications or plugins for it eventually. My final thoughts on the project are it was very, very difficult to grasp all of the greater concepts that they really have going on. I suggested if you were interested in the project to really do some research, because this video, as much as I wanted to be in depth, really just kind of touches the top of what the project is really doing. They're essentially trying to take all of the things that newer projects are doing and building now, but implementing all of these things into their own project and building basically everything from the ground up. As I talked about before, they're planning on implementing smart contracts, but they want to advance that and implement them to a further degree so that they're not the smart contracts that we know today. They will also in the future be utilizing sidechain interoperability and decentralized governance, which will allow for voting within a project to allocate funds for certain things. On top of all these things, they also want to be in compliance with all the major regulators. For the most part, this is why I think when you hear about Cardano or ADA, people often say, you know, they have high-reaching expectations or high-reaching goals, or I'll believe it when I see it. There's definitely a large amount of developmental time that's required to accomplish goals like this successfully. And projects that have a long roadmap ahead of them have time against them. People get bored, and with the ICO craze, a lot of times people are looking for a quick flip or something that's going to, you know, go 10x and make a lot of profit. So unfortunately, unless you're invested in the actual project or you believe that this project has a future, you may lose interest if this isn't going to happen as quickly as you'd like it to. So that brings me to what is live and functioning now on the Cardano platform. And that brings me to their first release of the part of the roadmap, and this is called Byron. This is the first generation of the settlement layer, and this is where the ADA token lives. Following Byron, the next major release of the Cardano platform is called Shelley, and it's scheduled to be released hopefully in the first half of 2018. During the Shelley phase, the system's going to evolve into a full-featured, fully independent, functioning cryptocurrency. And that comment leads me into the cons. Right now, the entire community is sort of all waiting with bated breath for the Shelley release. It's been under design for a while, but right now they are basically a centralized currency and they have a functioning wallet. And they're in what's referred to, or what they refer to as, the bootstrap era. This means a fixed, predefined amount of users have control over the blockchain via nodes, or what they refer to as bootstrap stakeholders. The purpose of the bootstrap era is to address the concern that at the beginning of the mainnet, the majority of the stake will probably be offline. The bootstrap era is going to be ended when the network stabilizes and the most of the stake is online and also Shelley is implemented. At this early stage, even though Ouroboros is turned on, the consensus is locked to private nodes until the system gains momentum. They've got a lot of hurdles to overcome and they've got a lot of FUD surrounding the project. I think because the project's been in development for so long that people kind of see it maybe as a red flag. I, however, think that 2018 is going to be a really big year for blockchain tech in general, but I'm really curious to see what Cardano brings to the table, considering Shelley's supposed to be released midway through the year, and who knows, maybe if we're lucky, it'll come out sooner. I'm going to have a ton of links to put in the description as sources for this video, so if you're interested, look over them. I would suggest attempting to read the white paper. I will say that their website is really informative. The good news is that I didn't lose my voice halfway through the video, which is what I was worried was going to happen. So I want to thank you guys for peer pressuring me into doing it today, and as usual, I want to thank you again for watching, and I will see you guys soon.